Breaking news, Geraldo was born with a tail.
Dude, that's private.
Hello and welcome to Simulacrum News. I'm Don Mahogany with my co-anchor Geraldo Lassenum, who isn't here at the moment.
Guys, I'm here. I'm here. Okay. Oh. Okay. I'm here. We can start the news.
Awesome.
Sorry, I'm late. Okay.
All right. Where were you? We're already live on the air.
I had to take my grandmother to the vet. Good morning, Bloomfield. Welcome to Simulacrum News. I'm Geraldo Lassenum with my co-anchor Don Mahogany.
I already opened for. Never mind. This week in the U.S. of America. President Obama has now confirmed that we are at war with Finland.
Sauli Niinistö and Barack Obama were in a heated discussion about who could throw a boot the furthest.
I guess you could say that they wouldn't admit defeat.
Obama has sent word to create a national boot throwing league. Let's go to our sportscaster for more information.
Thanks, guys. As we all know, boot throwing is truly a game of inches. In the first ever NBTL game last night, the Rapid City Roughhousers beat the Boston Bad Boys by 12 and a half feet.
I guess you can say that they booted them out of the competition.
In rugby news, a bunch of scantily clad Australian guys pushed each other in the mud over a ball. More on that later. The Hacky Sack World Cup started today in Uzbekistan with Yemen defeating the Republic of Congo 23 sacks to 16 sacks. They will go on to face the United Arab Emirates in round two. Back to America. Football. The Dallas Cowboys receiver, Dez Bryant, tore his ACL after sprinting into the locker room, crying, and slipping on an ice cube. This has caused a mass hysteria in the greater Dallas area, and Tony Romo has requested a day off to deal with his feelings. Lastly, The women's PGA Tour made its tri-annual stop in Schenectady, New York, in which the event was so boring that everyone fell asleep after the first hole. Back to you guys.
In older news, World War II has finally ended. We won! And now to newer news. All state has disappeared.
That's right. Nebraska has just vanished out of thin air, leaving an enormous gaping void in the middle of the country. Some are even calling it the Grander Canyon.
People all over the world are baffled and panicking about how this could possibly happen. Some people believe aliens harvested Nebraska for their sweet, delicious, juicy, succulent corns.
Oh. Yes, at least a million people are now MI action, possibly being probed and experimented on as we speak.
However, scientists now have access to our Earth's lower mantle and core, which is information we have never been able to gain access to before.
Double, however, this might upset our Earth's gravity fields and atmosphere. The Earth may be on the verge of crumbling in on itself, as well as losing its hold on the moon.
The moon's an egg.
The moon's an egg?
The moon is an egg.
The moon is an egg? Huh, well, this is becoming quite the existential crisis.
I guess you could say the Earth's survival is walking on eggshells. We are now waiting for scientists in the military to hatch a plan. We'll be back after this short break.
Emergency staff meeting in 10 seconds. Everybody in right now. Sarah, not you.
Sarah orders the pizza.
Fine, come on in. All right. First order of business. We're going to order a pizza today. So, what do we want on pizza? I think it's Esteban.
Ketchup!
God, it's always ketchup.
Ew.
Every time. Alright, done. It's okay. You order next week. Alright.
Fine.
Keep going.
Alright, I'll prevent anybody from making any more brash decisions. Alright, next on the list. Are we going to cover this huge oil spill that I just got in from San Francisco? Or should we cover the new Squirrel National Olympics?
Oil spill? Oh my gosh, that's horrible. Of course we have to cover that. Squirrel?
All right, shut up, intern. You know what? All in favor of doing the Squirrel Aquatic Olympics? All right, so the jury is in. Sarah is stupid and Operation Squirrel is a go. Perfect.
Last order of business is who would like to be sponsored by for the next three episodes. We have two submissions, Felix's Corn Dogs and the BBC.
The BBC wants to sponsor us?
Everyone go down BBC being our sponsor?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
All right, Bradley Balloons Company it is. So it's decided, meeting adjourned.
Oh, done. Oh, welcome back. Turns out that the Squirrel Aquatic Olympics that we were looking oh so forward to covering has been canceled due to the San Francisco oil spill.
Here's our newest member, Sarah Miller, reporting on scene.
Unfortunately, our budget for traveling is pretty tight right now. So, instead of wasting our money sending Sarah to San Fran, we decided to send her somewhere more local. Sarah?
We don't even have a budget for traveling. I'm still in the building. Anyway, Sarah Miller here reporting from a Bloomfield High School water fountain in New Jersey, not San Francisco. Recently, the Armstrong Oil Company went on their weekly delivery to the San Francisco Bay, and unfortunately, things did not go as planned. The captain of the ship fell asleep while operating the ship and crashed into the docks. The oil from the ship leaked into the water, causing millions of dollars in damages. Oh my God, look at this. This fountain is so gross. The what? No, no way. You did not just splash it on me. No, actually, you know what? This is ridiculous. I don't even want to be on this show anymore. Now I have to go back to our studio where we don't make enough money because of two idiots who are anchoring the show don't make us enough money, so I quit.
Thank you, Sarah. So, Don, how do you think she did for her first story?
Well, you know what? I think she's a work in progress. Her presence is decent, but she was easily flustered. If I could use only one word, I would say severely unimpressed.
That's too... Never mind. Wait. Did she quit?
Who cares?
That means I'm single again.
You were never in a relationship with Sarah. How many times do we have to go through this?
The love is real.
Your love is as real as something that is not real.
That's deep, my friend. Deep indeed. Go to simulacrumnews.net/votesarah to vote on Sarah's performance or tweet the hashtag #SaveSarah.
Back to the news. There's ghosts to boot. In Canada, there's been a specter sighting in Saskatchewan.
Multiple reports from our friendly neighbors in the north have indicated various hauntings in the greater central Saskatchewan residential area, leaving many citizens frozen in peril.
Well, they certainly are no Patrick Swayzes.
No, not quite.
The ghost has been reported to be in the form of a short Peyton Manning. The ghost visits convenience stores and does not allow customers to purchase Gatorade.
First responders have named him the Alligator Ghost.
Let's leave the naming and the entomology to the professionals, shall we?
Sorry. On that note, we'll move into Marcy Summers with the weather. Marcy?
Thanks, guys. Today we're going to be looking at the weather, so get your raincoats ready because we're going to be having plenty of sunshine. Monday through Thursday, we're having a beautiful scorching dry heat in the high 90s. And it's amazing. Like, I love it. And you can see it's going to be really pretty right
broken
from this, right? And I mean, like, I was in
the I don't think so, man.
So, like,
should we tell her?
It's going to be crazy.
No, let's just let her keep going.
No?
No.
Friday we will get a massive rainstorm. I predict major flash floods, which will pair very badly with the nastiest thunderstorm we have ever seen in this lifetime. 90 through 100 mile per hour winds, and probably a tornado or two, maybe seven. Who knows? Weather is a beautiful mystery. In other news, there was a hurricane in the Caribbean that ravaged the landscape. Jack Sparrow's hat fell off into the water. It has not yet been found, and...
Marcy?
Now back for the rest of the week. Upper 90s all week with winds being almost non-existent. It will be a beautiful beach weekend. Some of the best weather I have ever seen. Take the kids, just preferably your own kids.
Yes, certainly your own kids.
Wait, I'm getting something. Breaking news! We have reports of a kidnapping in downtown Bluefield. Is he in the studio? Yeah? Okay.
Yeah. Our sources say that local 12-year-old Steve Baloney has been asleep for over 14 hours. Wow, that's amazing.
You know what? Let's see if we can get him over here. Wow. How convenient. The police work quite quickly in this town.
Guys, I wasn't really kidnapped. I had a rough night, so...
Nonsense. You were kidnapped.
Nope, definitely not the police reported wrong.
Blasphemy. The police are never wrong. How dare you discredit the fine, fine work the police have done.
To protect
and serve!
Serve. Yeah. You know, I think it's time to let this interviewee go for now.
No, are you kidding? We're just getting started. So, Steve, describe your experience working with a sick and twisted individual that would dare snatch another innocent human being into his cold, dark clutches.
Well, I was quite warm, in my room, under the covers, in my bed.
Ah, so he held you captive in your own room, eh?
Well, he let me go after. The guy in my dream, I mean, he was holding me Twinkies! He was holding Twinkies!
Oh, so you were dreaming and not kidnapped. That does explain why you were asleep for so long.
Yeah, I was really tired.
Oh, well, that's the end of that story. Local boy falls asleep, nothing more.
Hold on, Don. Steve?
Yes?
Why was your shoe found in the park?
All right, well, that's all the time that we have. We'll be right back after these messages. He left.
He left?
Yeah.
We didn't even get to pay him for being on the show yet.
I'll bring him to his mailbox later.
Guys, did you hear about the incoming tsunami from China? 1,800-foot waves. Can I go cover it, please?
Marcy, we can't afford to send you to China. But, we don't have the funds for that.
But it's like a tsunami that waves never reach that size. I need this wave. I really, really do.
All right, we don't need this wave.
But I need it.
It's not safe anyway. You'll either drown or get swept out to sea.
I thought you quit. You're out of here.
I would die for this story. Tsunamis are Mother Nature's red blanket of love and
compassion. I'm leaving now. Now I'm leaving. I applied to other jobs at other news stations. With my credentials, I can get hired anywhere I want.
Have fun with that one.
Wait, what? You're leaving? But I love you. And I'll miss you. Don't go.
I hate you.
Wait!
Welcome back. This is Simulacrum News. I'm Don Mahogany, and that is Geraldo Lassen.
You're watching the Greater Essex County Area's number 9 news network.
We will now bring you over to Bloomfield High School for our weekly segment on education in America.
Due to our recent vacancy in the field reporter position, we're pleased to introduce Sarah's interim replacement, Mr. Harold, who recorded a nice educational video for us.
Thanks, guys. Glad to be part of the team. Today we'll be discussing different ways to save your planet. Did you know that the Earth's ozone layer protects us from about 97% of the sun's harmful emissions? Did you? Well, it's true. Unfortunately, since the Industrial Revolution, Humans have been releasing harmful gases and other chemicals into the atmosphere. This has significantly depleted the ozone. Isn't that terrible? Luckily for us, there are many ways to change this trend. One way to do this is to walk or ride your bike to close destinations instead of driving. Cars emit many harmful gases that make our Earth very sicky-poo. Another thing we can do is turn off your lights and unneeded devices all around your home, including sinks and toilets. This will save electricity, water, and use less of our Earth's valuable earthy resources. Our Earth's atmosphere is vital to our survival. Adding CO2 emissions is harmful to our planet, and we need to restore the oxygen levels once again. The way to do this is to not only emit less harmful gases, but to emit more beneficial gases. You can do this right now, simply by planting trees and plants around your homes. You can even make a garden and make a nice healthy dinner for your whole family every night for free. You can have meat in your mouth every night if you want. You can do this all while helping your Earth get back to its original healthy oxygen abundant condition. Another great way to help your beautiful planet would be to recycle. So instead of throwing away a bunch of plastic water bottles, buy a metal water bottle that you can use all the time. When plastic water bottles are thrown away, they are put in landfills and stay in the environment for a very, very long time. This is not good! If you do use plastic or paper, separate them from the normal garbage to be sent to recycling plants so they can be reused effectively, saving precious materials. All this pollution has a very positive amount of negative effects on our weather. Here is my close friend and weather broadcaster you all know and love, Marcy, to further discuss this problem.
Hey guys, so all this air pollution has ravaged the atmosphere and has actually caused a major climate change that we all know as global warming. This has caused drastic temperature change throughout the entire world. Some major consequences have been unusual weather patterns, increase of the sea levels, and the melting of the polar ice caps. If the polar ice caps melt, then there will be rises in the sea level, destruction all over the world, mass tsunamis, hurricanes, freak storms. It's okay.
Well, thanks. Thanks, guys, for that wonderful segment. Our Earth is definitely something worth saving. You know what else is worth saving? Sarah. Let's cut to an exclusive interview with the Sarah Miller.
All right, I think I see her coming out. Let's. Is that her? Hey, Sarah. Oh, wow. Fancy seeing you here. Huh? Didn't expect that one at all.
Get away from me.
All right, wait. Hold on. Now that we have this convenient camera crew with us, don't you have any time for some questions?
No, leave me alone.
All right, great. So, how miserable has your sorry life been since you left?
Actually, for your information, I just got an offer from WNEW to be their field reporter, and I'm gonna take it.
You do realize that WNEW is our parent company, right?
I don't care. Anywhere is better away from you two.
You also realize that their headquarters are located in Montana. Nobody cares about Montana.
Nobody cares about you!
How could you say something like that? Ah, I scoff about your remark. We're like a big family, you know. I'm the great golden boy, Marcy's the fun dog, Esteban is the distant cousin, and Geraldo's your husband and you're his trophy wife.
Who's Geraldo?
Him. Wait, what is he doing here?
Is he drooling?
He didn't come, wait, hold on, who's anchoring?
And then the government decided to get revenge on all those who dared litter. Die, litterers! Die! Die! Die!
Oh, all right, whatever. Well, that's kind of all the questions we have, I think.
All right,
oh, wait, one more. Our viewers want to know, how much do you weigh?
I'm out of here!
Who let the dogs out?
Was nice, the party was bumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started in calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a bullwhip shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the dance people had a ball, couldn't believe on
puffy. Get back, you flea infested mongrel. Gonna tell myself I might not get angry. Hey,
Welcome back to Simulacrum News.
To end tonight's newscast, we bring you back to Esteban and Marcy for a bit we call ESTEBANQNA.
Hey Esteban, it looks like we have a ton of questions from our viewers.
A ton? That's great. Our viewers have a ton of important questions for us.
Well, this is the first question from @DiscoKitty7. Is Sarah Miller coming back?
Not important enough. Next question.
Sarah Miller is a very important woman.
Okay, next question is from @ChabbyTrab. What's up with Geraldo and Sarah?
That is a great question. So they—
We're in love.
Love. She may not say so, but we'll be together forever.
Okay, you're touching me, go away.
Like
this is our segment. Anyway, apparently they're in love. You heard it here. Romance brewing between two of our Simulacrum News reporters. Marcy, next question.
This comes from @LegallyBrunette. Marcy, what do you think about this freak drizzle we're experiencing? Well, that is an excellent question. The rain is extremely mild, and I'm sure you can go your whole entire day totally dry. Now the wind. Whoa. The wind is a whopping 5 miles per hour northeast. Don't worry, there's no need to go head to your storm cellars by 6 p.m. tonight. Because by 6 p.m. the temperature will reach a scorching 60 degrees and the rain will have, wait for it, stopped. The rain will have stopped. If only I could have, it lasted
okay,
a little
Marcy,
longer.
Okay, Marcy, no need for another
stopped.
Breakdown.
It stopped.
Oh, okay, Geraldo, Don, please.
No.
I apologize for that. Let's continue. Next question is from @TheaterForLife. What is wrong with Marcy Summers? That is a very interesting question. Unfortunately, we only have a half hour show and we don't have enough time to cover everything. Let's go to our final question. This comes from @inediblegarbagecan. Okay. What is the capital of Wyoming? Well, Wyoming doesn't exist, so there isn't a capital. That's all for ESTEBAN Q&A. Back to you, John and Geraldo.
I do get a kick out of those rolling jokes. Invigorating reporting. Always glad to hear the voice of the people.
I agree. Great stuff. We will conclude tonight's episode on the lighter side of the news. The sun rose today.
Indeed it did, Geraldo. Indeed it did. Well, that's all the time that we have for today. From all of us at Simulacrum News, have a good night.
Don't panic and always carry a towel. Signing off.
Yeah, I think it was good.